Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Ravindra, and in this video, I'm going to talk about creative workflow using Kanban Board. And for that, I'm using Trello. Well, I'm using the free version of Trello, and this is not a sponsored post. So you can follow along and you can create your own account over there and follow this process so that you can be much more productive in doing whatever task it can be. I'm using it for YouTube and for my blog, and you can use it the same way for any activity that you're doing. Say gardening or whatever it is. Because I work in an IT company and I have been following this agile methodology since 2014 or 15, I have been using this tool called Jira or Jira. And there is another similar tool by the same parent company, which is from the Atlassian market as of this recording. And the tool is Trello, which is much more colorful than using the regular Jira. And you can track all of your tasks and what tasks that you need to do. So those things can be tracked using this particular app. So once you create an account, you can access this account using your mobile device as well as using the web version. So I've got this app installed on my mobile device. It's a free version that I'm using, and you can even access that using the desktop version. So every time I get an idea, it can be while walking or while taking a bath or when I'm in an office meeting, and whenever I get an idea, I just make a note of it and add it to backlog. So I've created a column named backlog, where I've got n number of stories or n number of tasks or ideas, I can say. So those stories and tasks are, again, those are agile terms. Basically, it's nothing but an idea over here. So every time I get an idea, which won't last long in our mind, so I just make a note of that. Well, prior to using this tool, I used to make a note of it in Google Notes or Notepad or somewhere, but then it used to be everywhere and I used to forget about it. So I wanted everything to be in one place so that it was always stored somewhere in the backlog or in the archives, and I can use that while doing the sprint planning. So with these ideas added to backlog, I will not run out of ideas for my YouTube. What used to happen before was whenever I used to think of creating a new YouTube video, I used to sit for hours thinking of what video to do next, and I used to waste the entire day. It was hard to remember those ideas whichever had come to my mind because I never made a note of any of those. Now that I keep a track of every idea that I get in my mind and I just make a note of it somewhere, it's easier for me to pick one idea from backlog and then start making videos out of it. So I have all those things created and added to my backlog, and well, I'm following the agile methodology over here, and I follow monthly sprint or 4-week sprint, and every start of every month or on weekends, though it can be the last weekend of the month or the first weekend of the next month. So I do the sprint planning and decide on, say, 2 videos a week or 1 video a week, or it can be even 3 videos a week. So beginning of month May, it's 2nd of May. And as you can see, all the videos that are to be published in the month of May, I've already completed those. So that is sprint 21 is 2021 this year, and also the month May. So I want to publish 8 videos this month. So I've created all of those, and you can see those things I've already uploaded and it's ready to publish. So as you can see here, if I go to YouTube Studio and if I create, click on content, all those videos that are to be published in the month of May, along with the thumbnail description and everything, all the keyword research, everything is updated here and it is ready for publishing in the month of May. So right now I am working on the next sprint. I'm going back to the board. So because I'm publishing 2 videos a week, and in the month of June, if I continue to publish 2 videos a week, then I'll have to publish 9 videos. So I've picked up 9 tasks from this backlog and I've added it to ready to start, and I've color coded it in such a way that it's easy for me to track. So I've created these labels with a sprint name at, and it's easy for me to keep a track of these because it's all color coded here and it's clearly saying that it is sprint 6, and it's all these things are ready to start. So this entire month of May, I'll be working on videos that are to be published in the month of June. This was not the case earlier, where I used to think about the video on the day of publishing the video. Think of that video, edit that video, and I couldn't ever stick onto a proper schedule. So if you want to stick onto a proper schedule when it comes to YouTube or publishing it on YouTube, this is the best way I can think of doing. And also I do bulk recording, so this is easier for me to keep a track. So as soon as I do the sprint planning here, I add all the details here, description and checklist on what I'm going to speak in the video. So that's more of scripting part. Once I'm done with the recording, I just push it to this column. So I push it to clips and music. So this is where I'll have the clip ready for editing purpose. And also this is where I will download the required music from. I'm using royalty free music, and I'm downloading music from Artlist here. So I'll try to download, or I've already put a star mark on some of the music that I'm going to use, and I will directly fetch that or just download it or go to the library wherever I have already saved it. So I've saved some of the music onto my local hard disk, and now that is ready to be used. So I'll directly drag it to Premiere Pro and I follow the template there, which I'll be explaining in a separate video. So I start editing those and it will be pushed to editing column. So once I'm done with the editing and once it's ready to be published, I'll push it to ready to publish. And once the video is uploaded, once the video processing is done, once the copyright check is done, once I've added all of the details to that particular video, like the links and all those things are the template that I follow, and then the thumbnail and also a few keywords. So all these things are done, and also I update the thumbnail here. So once I've completed that, I push it to ready to publish, and it will be lying over here till the video is published. So once the video is published and once it is live, I push it to done status. So if you look into this column, it's 2nd of May now, and just 2 days back I published this video of the lockdown impact on my photography business. So this went live just 2 days back and I pushed that to done status, which can be pushed to archive later on. So you can see the complete list of all the previous 100 videos that I've uploaded here. Or that's the creative process that I follow. So right now I have this my creative workflow with Kanban board and ready to start. So now I'm doing the recording. So I'm almost done with the recording of this video. So I'll be pushing it to clips and music. So once this is done, I do bulk recording. So as and when I complete one of these stories or tasks, or ideas, I just push it to clip and music column. So I usually do 4 recordings in one shot, or what I call it as bulk or batch recording, and then start doing editing during my weekdays, because this is where I spend most of my time, and also the editing takes even more time. So this is something that I do after my office hours, late in the evening or early in the morning. Well, by doing so, I complete all of my tasks for the next month usually by the first 15 or 20 days, or maximum 3 weeks time. And I do all of my editing and recording during public holidays and on weekends. So this is the process that I follow, and this is called Kanban, and you can easily keep a track of all the activities that you're going to publish. Well, there are other tools like Notion, Jira, and a number of tools that are available for free as well as the paid version. Because I'm a single user, I'm not having a team over here, this works perfectly fine. But if you're having a team, if you want to invite others, then that's where you need to go for a paid version. And also, the paid version isn't that costly. By the way, this is not a sponsored post, and you're free to use whatever tool you want. So that's the creative workflow that I'm using the Kanban board. And this really helps in saving a lot of your time, and especially in planning and executing a particular task that you want. It can be for YouTube or for any other task. I am using it for my YouTube and for my blog. So hope you like this video. If you like it, then go ahead, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit on that bell icon. You can even buy me a coffee. There is a link in the description to support my work. Thanks for watching. Cheers.